Now, welcome back to the programme. Stay in touch with us. Keep your texts and your comments coming in. We have finished our Mulligan's Pharmacy competition regarding Faith Lake House Hotel at present. So we'll announce our winner. Actually, we have it here now, just before we're going to talk in a minute to Deirdre. But we're going to announce this. My mother always said, worrying alone never changed anything. I found this so true after many a year of eye rolling on my behalf. I think especially of these particular times, how great this advice is. She also was a fan of, don't come running to me when you break your legs. I'd love this for my mum. That's from Mary Louise O'Sullivan from Kill in County Waterford. Mary Louise O'Sullivan from Kill. I love that one. Don't come running to me when you break your legs. Children, if you're listening to this, ask your mammy or tell your mammy what her favourite bit of advice is or favourite words are, because that you get some interesting conversations. And there's going to be a lot of people having great conversations, getting to know people a lot better over the next few weeks regarding spending time together in houses. And again, stay positive, everybody. Stay positive as much as possible. Take every day as it comes. I'm going to talk now to Deirdre Hennessy. Good morning. Good morning, Deirdre.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm grand. Thanks, Deirdre. You have to get on with it, don't you? Some days you'd feel a bit down. Other days you have to be up, and you have to just not put a false kind of a face on it, but just take every day as it comes. It is going to be difficult. You have to accept that people are worried. You have to accept that some people in particular have anxiety. They're going to be stressed, all those things, but you have to get on with it. And that's what we're talking to you about now. You're a teacher in the Mercy. You have three children at home aged 7, 6 and 2, is it?
That's correct, yeah.
What's their names?
So Amelia, Riri and Tig.
Lovely names. Very nice. I like Amelia in particular. Tell me, how are you getting on? Firstly, from a parenting perspective, tell me, how have you been getting on for the last week? Then we'll talk about the teaching aspects of things. But tell me about the parenting aspect first.
OK, well, it is tough. I mean, especially being stuck at home, and especially with the 2-year-old as well. I mean, I've decided in my wisdom to start potty training him as well, which isn't, you know, I suppose the best.
Fair play.
Yeah, but no, keeping them active and keeping them busy is the main thing. And, you know, they do pick up on everything. Children are sponges. I mean, they do see the worry in your face, and they do try and listen into the conversation. So it's all about limiting their exposure, but, you know, not shielding them completely, because they do want to know what's going on. I mean, they're very aware that something is going on. I mean, they're at home, for goodness sake. They should be at school. Their routine is disrupted. So, you know, it's all about putting a positive spin on things and, you know, making sure they know this is only a temporary measure, and that we're not on holidays. We still have to do some work, and keeping them in the routine is so key to this, because, I mean, it's so easy just to sit on the couch in our jammies and let the days all mingle into one, but keeping them busy and keeping them active is the main thing, you know, and fighting them apart as well, because they will fight. I mean, they're kids at the end of the day, they're siblings, you know, they are going to fight, and it's about giving them their own time and their own space as well, you know, and they have a room full of toys. They have, you know, things that you can discover that you can do at home without even being schoolwork. There's so many things you can access.
I know.
At home as well.
And what we're going to do tomorrow for a little sort of a special thing on the programme tomorrow, Deirdre, is we're going to ask people to text us in. They can start it today. Text us in the favourite game that you've played at home now over the last week, or that you're playing at home.
Brilliant idea.
Some people are playing Uno, card games.
Yeah.
Others playing this card game Julie is playing, where you put the card into the headband and you have to try and guess what it is, and all those different
Monopoly,
games.
Monopoly, Scrabble, Twister, Jigsaws, everything.
Yeah.
Bring them all out, dust them all off.
And you know, another very important thing, Deirdre, is for parents and guardians, or those that are minding children as well, to realise that you yourself can become anxious and stressed. And there's a time to go to the bedroom, to take a break for half an hour, to say to the children, yeah, sit and watch this telly now for a half an hour. I need a break myself.
Yeah. I mean, we're so on. I mean, people are probably very conscious of, you know, people saying constantly, oh, we must limit their screen time. And we do need to limit their screen time. But also, there's no point in completely limiting as well, especially in the situation we've now found ourselves in. I mean, what you said is so true. We need to look after our mental health as well. And there's no harm in sticking on a bit of Paw Patrol or Peppa Pig and leaving them at it for a few minutes. I mean, that's their break as well. You know, it's a little break for them to just to chill out and sit down and relax. And you get your time to just drink a cup of tea, even just sit and flick on your phone yourself, whatever you want to do, you know.
Tell me about the teaching aspect of things, because I know a lot of students are earnest. They want to actually do a little bit of study. They want to keep up their work. Some teachers. Some schools have done this distance learning. They've got Instagram classes going. Others haven't yet done that. It's difficult for children to keep the studies going, isn't it?
It is difficult. And what I would say is just to not worry about regressing or falling behind in school, because every single child in the country, and not just in the country, in the world, are in the same boat. So, I mean, teachers are well prepared for this. We know what's going to happen. We know what's coming down the line. And when we do get back to the classroom, and we will get back to the classroom, I mean, we will just adjust our curriculum accordingly, and we will just meet their needs and start from there again. I mean, we are experts at this. We have been differentiating the curriculum for years. So that's one thing that they're not to worry about. I mean, they're not going to fall behind. We will, everything will be fine. And, you know, again, try not to stick to concrete school hours either. Don't say, okay, I must sit down from 9 until 2:30 and study, because that's not going to work. I mean, that's not realistic. In a school environment, yes, but you must remember that in a school environment, you also have your lunch break and your activity breaks, and take those breaks as well. But I mean, there's lots of things. I mean, teachers send home packs as well. And I mean, try to limit them. Don't try and rush through them. You don't have to get, there's no time frame on when they have to be done. And I mean, the schools are closed, but the teachers are still working. So the school websites and blogs are a great way to keep, you know, updated. And there's a lot of work being put up there and a lot of websites and that. And again, it's only guidance. It's not something that you have to get done. Just get through it at your own pace and just keep chipping away at it. I would advise as well, trying not to start new concepts, things that are completely new to you, because, I mean, you'll only end up getting frustrated, and you won't, and when you come back to school, you might find that the teacher has a completely different way of learning it, and that could lead to frustration and tension. And just keep going at a certain level, and don't try to stress yourself out about it. I mean, things will get done, and we will get back to normal eventually. I mean, there's plenty of websites out there that, you know, you can go through, and there's one that have a list of websites. Kidsactivities.com is great, because they have an entire list of education companies that are offering free subscriptions because of school closing. So you can go on there and you can get download whatever you want for your own age group and keep going with that. There's also plenty of resources.
There are, and I'll tell you what we'll do, Deirdre. The advice you're giving is excellent. We might come back to you on Monday morning and just update this and just see how things are going. On a personal level, have you got a favourite Eurovision song?
Rock and Roll Kids.
Okay, we'll try and find that. Listen, Deirdre, thank you so much for joining us. Deirdre Hennessy.
No problem.
And to the lads, mind yourselves and take care, okay?
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you very much. Now, keep your texts and comments coming in, 083-333-975 or text or WhatsApp. Just got a message in from somebody there. I won't mention her name. She sent in a few texts and then she said, oh, sorry, wrong WhatsApp chat group. Thankfully, nothing bad in it. I'm just laughing here myself, and she's got the monkey hands up to the face, the embarrassment of it all. I'm going to talk to Bernadette in a minute about relationships and families in close quarters. Firstly, your chance to win a nice competition as courtesy of our original Irish hotels. 2-night breakaway, including breakfast and dinner, 1 night for 2 people sharing. It's Dingle Benners Hotel in Kerry. Something nice, something positive to give away in these times of difficulties. So you can use it later in the year, anytime later in the year. All we want to do is text in Gimme a Break, G-I-M-M-E, Gimme a Break to 083-333-975, or you can call 051-846-123. Father Martin Tobin says, great mass every day. It's streamed live on the Mooncoin Parish website, Tuesday to Friday at 9:30, Rosary at 9:15, Saturday evening at 7, Sunday at 11. The man who rang into Audrey says he does a great mass. So there you go. Bernadette, good morning.
Good morning, Damien. I hope you're well.
I'm very well, thank you. How are you feeling yourself?
Very well so far. Touching wood all the time.
Very good. We're doing a competition this morning, and we're also doing our little Eurovision special thing on the programme, Bernadette, because Eurovision's now cancelled, so we want people to think of their favourite Eurovision song. Do you remember this one, Bernadette? Have a listen to this one. Do you remember that? You do?
I do. Vaguely in the back of my mind. Actually, we were just talking the other day. I don't know why. Do you remember
that? That's a little piece by Nick Cole. A little piece by Nicole.
Mending their nets in Kinsale. I think it was a contestant in the Eurovision. I don't think it ever got through, but for some reason it stayed in my mind.
Excellent. Listen, we were just talking to a mammy there a few minutes ago, Deirdre Kinsella. She's a teacher and she's a parent at home, minding three young children, 7, 6 and 2. Tell me, it's difficult. First thing we have to understand, we're in a difficult situation, so people have to understand people's limits and people's, I suppose, foibles and everything. You're going to get to know people better than you've ever known them before, aren't you?
Well, yes, absolutely. I mean, for sure, it is very difficult. And, you know, the thing is, you're going to get to know yourself more than you ever did before. You know, what really strikes me about all of this is it is stripping away all of the busyness in our lives, all of the things that distract us from, you know, our real core self. You know, we keep ourselves busy in many ways. I speak now as somebody who is going through this myself. You know, we're all in this together, you know. I've had a couple of outbursts, uncharacteristic outbursts myself this week so far. But, you know, I think...
Yeah, I had one yesterday, and you just have to apologise and you just have to move out of the room, maybe go outside. Yeah,
you know,
go on.
I think apologise quickly and forgive quickly. You know, but it's not easy. And you know, particularly the sort of the imposed isolation bit and, you know, children and working from home or maybe having lost one's job. It's like it's huge to have to cope with, you know. So we can only do so much. But I think one of the things we can do is, you know, it all feels like it's totally out of our control, and to a large degree it is. But what is within my control? What can I do? And listening to, you know, Simon Harris this morning, you know, you can wash your hands, you could do all of those kinds of things. But with the children, you know, I saw something running around on as a meme saying, you know, if you keep them alive, you're doing okay. Don't worry about stimulating their brains. Throw a few fish fingers at them, you know, just being facetious about it. But, you know, give yourself a break. Good enough parenting, you know. It's all different, you know. Now, there's lots of articles in the newspapers and online and everywhere with activities for children. And we are actually blessed with not social media, but technology. You know, we're not isolated all alone in our homes with only the wireless to listen to, although that would be wonderful too, Damien, especially with your good self. But, you know, there are many things you can do with children like that too. Take them out for walks or bike rides or everything, and keeping social distancing, all that. But I'd say, you know, more so, what is it that each of us needs to keep that sense of groundedness and reduce our stress, you know, with everyone at the home? And it is not easy. But like that too, even if, well, the one thing I would say to people, and I will have to remind myself of this, go back to the breath. Take a breath. And in fact, for anyone who's feeling anxious, you can go online and learn how to belly breathe correctly. And it really does help to bring down the stress levels and the anxiety levels. So one thing we can...
Belly breathe.
Is to breathe and take that breath, give it a space. You know, it's what also strikes me about relationships is, you know, John Gottman, I've often talked about the four horsemen of the apocalypse. This is rife for them to come charging through all relationships, and their criticism, defensiveness, which would be the two key ones we all use, and then there's contempt and stonewalling. So the antidotes to those are complain without blame, don't blame the other person, you know, explain or try and communicate, I'm feeling anxious, instead of you're a dirty so-and-so, you haven't washed your hands, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Take responsibility for one's own behaviour. The antidote to contempt is respect. Respect each other and respect that we're all in this together and everybody is under strain. And then the one to the stonewalling, which a lot of men tend to do, and it cuts them off from people, is to find a way to self-soothe. So it all really comes, in a very simplistic way, it comes back to self-soothing. What do I need to reduce my own stress levels so that I'm not taking them out on everybody else?
Very important advice there, yeah. And I know people will come to find their own ways of doing things. I know a person said to me in the past as well, never compare families. Like,
yeah,
there will be times when there's so many little simple bits of advice. You just have to step back, take a deep breath, as you say, learn to belly breathe. Go into your bedroom if you want, take a half an hour out, go outside. And maybe, I remember talking to somebody about this before, Bernadette, setting up a little system so that you say to your child or you say to your husband or wife or partner, if you're feeling stressed, if we're just about to have an argument, whatever, let's use a word, a touch point that literally allows us to walk outside. One of us takes a break, you know, because that honesty is what's going to get us through this.
Absolutely, Damien. And that is really, actually, it's quite key, you know, to recognise when your own triggers are starting. Do you know, that stress, whether it's the heartbeat, whether it's, you know, getting cross or whatever, and to have that word, whatever will work, kind of a humorous one can work sometimes too, but, you know, to say, and both agree, we call it a timeout, the same as we use with children, and step away from it, take wherever, if you've only got a corner of the house, maybe put a chair in the corner, and it's like, when I'm sitting here, I'm trying to bring myself down. Nobody come near me for a moment. You know, there's lots of small things that we can do. But
there are.
Again, it's simple, but it's not easy.
Listen, Bernadette, it's lovely talking to you again. Bernadette Ryan, our relationship counsellor. And I think advice from the likes of yourself is going to be so, so important in the coming weeks. And a lot of people texting in to say thank you very much. I'd love to talk to you again next week, if you wouldn't mind, Bernadette.
We'd love to do that as well, Damien.
It's really
in
good.
In the meantime, everyone stay well.
Yeah, we do get a great response from the conversations we have. Bernadette, thanks very much, and mind yourself, okay?
Thanks, Damien. You too.
Thank you, Bernadette Ryan there. Now, we'll call out those numbers again for the Kyo practice. A woman who phoned in, she's 81, and says her husband is 87. He was on hold for quite a while, up to 2 hours, and couldn't get through. I know the phone lines have been phenomenally busy, phenomenally busy. Text in, please, as well, for your competition. Give me a break, 083 333 375. And we're nearly there with our Eurovision competition this morning. It's only our little private competition. Our main competition is the Give Me a Break competition, courtesy of Mulligan's Pharmacy. And it is our, sorry, this is courtesy of our original Irish hotels, and it's our weekend away in Dingle Benners Hotel in Kilkenny. That's original Irish hotels weekend away. Now, we're playing a lot of music this morning. I love this. I'm really getting into this now. Maybe I'm in the wrong profession. I should become an LDJ. I'll try and give Jeff a run for his money. People texting in their favourite songs. We have a request for this one, okay? This is especially for all the people working in care facilities and nursing homes, and anybody listening to this morning, either a staff member or somebody who is in a care or a nursing home. Let's hear you sing this loud. Welcome back. You're listening to our Eurovision special song day for the day that's in it. Hiya, Marion. How's it going?
Good, Damien. And you?
Asher, I'm grand. Marion Fitzgerald from Cummer Green. Do you have a favourite Eurovision song? Any song that you really like?
We'll have to go with Johnny Logan. What's Another Year?
What's Another Year? Yeah, I'll play a little bit of that now in a few minutes as well. Listen, it's lovely to talk to you. Thanks so much for ringing in. And I know you're a little bit nervous, but it'll be fine. Absolutely fine. So you give answer a few questions and see how you get on. Is that okay?
All right. Okay, Damien.
And you'll have 30 seconds, so you know what the way is. We're going to play our 30-second little timer, and I'll play that underneath you, so you won't even hear it. It'll be so quiet. And you just answer the questions as you go along and see how many you get, and see if you'll be in with a chance to win this nice prize. It'll be a weekend away in Dingle Benners Hotel in Kerry, courtesy of Original Irish Hotels. That'd be nice for later in the year, wouldn't it?
Oh, be lovely. Very nice.
And tell me, how are you getting on yourself?
Good, good. We're no grandchildren for the last week, so hopefully another week and we'll see them all.
Yeah.
We're FaceTiming and ringing them, so.
The FaceTiming is... It's lovely, isn't it, the FaceTiming, isn't it?
It is. It's brilliant, yeah. It is very good, yeah.
And are you finding it difficult? I suppose it is. It is hard, isn't it? Like, are you...
Yeah.
Keeping yourself busy,
but,
yeah.
Look, we have to find ourselves, don't we?
You do. Absolutely. And that is the main thing. That's the priority in all these times. And the grandchildren will be there when this is over, and there'll be nice hugs, and it'll just be lovely. It's going to bring people together, I think, Marion, in a way that we haven't seen before, you know?
I know, yeah. Yeah. Please God, it'll all blow over now and we'll all be back to normal by the summer.
Yes. So, Marion, we'll give it a shout. Marion Fitzgerald from Cummer Green. Thanks for calling in. You're our Give Me a Break competition winner today, contestant. See if you get as many as the people got earlier. So I'm going to go the questions, and just if you don't know them, just answer pass and move on, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Here we go. The stars on the US flag are what colour?
White.
What is the name of the coloured part of the eye?
the rest of them.
Which language, apart from English, is the official language of Canada?
French.
Sting was a member of which band?
Breed.
How many countries make up the United Kingdom? You can take your time. You can take your time now and answer this. How many countries make up the United Kingdom?
Four.
Well done.
Three. Sorry.
Four. No, you're right. You were right there first.
Yeah.
And what did you say? Sting was a member of what band? What did you say?
Police.
The Police. Yeah, I thought Police. That's what you said. Yeah, you got four right, which is excellent.
Oh.
I think that is, I'll have to double check now if that is better than the person this morning, but that's a good answer. Well done. The name of the coloured part of the eye is the iris. That's the only one you got wrong.
Oh, yeah.
You said
yeah.
The retina, so...
no hassle.
You weren't too far away there at all. And what did you say your favourite Johnny Logan song was? What's Another Year, is it?
Exactly, yeah.
So I'll tell you... Especially for you, Marion. We're going to play a little bit of this now. We're going to play more before the end of the hour. So, Marion Fitzgerald, thank you very much. And to you and all your family, take care and mind yourself, OK?
And to you and all at WLR, Jamie.
Thanks, Marion. What's Another Year there by Johnny Logan. Sean, good morning.
Good morning, Damien.
Have you got a favourite Eurovision song, Sean?
What's Another Year? Absolutely. You know, it's very appropriate now.
You're president of the Irish Postmasters Union. You're also postmaster in Tramore. There is some news you have for us regarding payments and opening hours of post office, and in particular, tomorrow for Pension Day. Tell us what it is, please, Sean.
Yeah, look, Damien, we're trying to work with everyone, communities, the public, in relation to our part to play in this awful crisis. We hope that the things that we take will help and keep everyone safe. What we're trying to do is we're trying to obviously limit the people that are coming into the post office. We have spatial distancing in operation. Next week, we hope, we're working with Social Welfare at the moment to enable double pensions to be paid for pensioners next week, and the week after then that all other payments will be paid a double week. That. So in other words, we're spacing out the people coming in and out of the post office, and we hope that will have a huge impact in relation to people being able to collect their money. And as I said it this morning, like, we're open since 8 this morning, we'll be opening again at 8 tomorrow morning. Again, just to alleviate the pressure in relation to people feeling that they might be on top of each other. And the funny thing is, I've had numerous customers in here this morning where they had their son and their daughter with them, and I said to the son or the daughter, you know, you don't need to bring your mummy, no need to bring your dad. They want to come. So, you know, we've got to be cognizant of the fact that this might be their only chance of getting out, and they want to be able to come and they want to be able to do it. And we'll try facilitate that, and we'll try help it, and we'll try keep the safe distance for everyone so that everyone will be sensible and everyone will be safe.
Very, very good advice there. Is there, for people that, can people ring you and ask you, Sean, like, can people ring the post office? I know you're mad busy, but are you able to answer the phones? You're so busy.
Look, we're getting to the phones. If anyone feels that they can't make it in and they want to nominate someone else to get their money, we have no problem with that at all. We facilitate as best we can. We've also, you know, stopped signing at the counter so people don't actually have to sign for their money again, which stops people picking up pens and hopefully not transmitting any further viruses within the system. So we're trying to make it as easy as possible for people. We understand that it is important that as an essential service we're there, and that the money is still generated around the local economy that keep most people in jobs, because unfortunately people are losing their jobs, and the last thing we want is more and more people losing them. So we believe, you know, that if we can be there, and we will be there as best we can to deliver this service to the people, we're not going anywhere. We will hopefully be here throughout this crisis and ensure that all the most vulnerable people and pensioners will get their money.
Sean, it's a pleasure talking to you and your staff and everybody working in post offices, and in particular, postmen and women around Waterford and the South East. Take care and stay safe,
yeah,
okay?
Let everyone be safe. Thanks, Damien.
Sean, thank you very much. Sean Martin there. And a lot of people have texted in the last few days regarding those that are doing the essential services, post people, postmen, post women, and the Gardaí and the Army, who are working hard as well. There's Garda members out there on the front line, and they're trying to get all their equipment sorted, trying to get their face masks and all their different things. And we want to say a special hello to them. Hello to Mary Gann in Holy Cross in Butlerstown. Damien, great show today. Actually, forgetting the stress of being on lockdown, I've even cleaned my windows, and the mixture of the music and the mixture of the information we're giving out. Part of what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and report, as I say, all people's concerns, all people's issues, and answer as many questions as possible in as calm and collected a way as possible. But also on different days, we're going to do, I suppose, themed programmes, and today's theme is the Eurovision. So your last shout out for our favourite Eurovision song. Coming up next, we have a woman from On Rhine who has another really good bit of advice about what to do if you are at home.
Join the WLR conversation on Twitter using hashtag DaishaToday.
With thanks to mulliganspharmacy.com.
Now, in a second, I'm going to be talking to Catherine down in On Rhine. Other people texting Bucks Fizz, Johnny Logan, Mickey Joe Hart, Niamh Kavanagh. Beautiful song, says Sheila Frisbee in Tremor. Some breaking news. The 2020 Leaving Cert and Junior Cert oral and practical exams have been cancelled. So the oral and practical exams for the Leaving and Junior have been cancelled. The Minister for Education has just said the exams are due to take place between March 23rd and April 3rd. Joe McHugh, Minister for Education, says all students who have been due to take those tests will be awarded full marks for that portion of the exam. Full marks for the portion of the exam. So if you weren't great at Oral Irish or Oral French, you're going to be getting full marks. You lucky sucker. Somebody has texted in, Chris Doran, If My World Stops Turning from Bridie. I've played a little bit of that. Catherine Foley, Diagwit.
Dias Morgut Damien.
Conas the Tatu. Gohunta Garfod. Conas Tatu Fain. Will do Gama.
Yeah, Maska Leshon Rodcho her father's Tit Mama Hashe Dokretta.
It is Dokretta. That's a very, very good phrase. I remember that word Oskwale, the Dokretta. It's a great, great phrase. Listen, you're down in On Rhine. You have a lovely idea, and I want people to think about this. We know you're author of Beyond the Breakwater, Memories of Home, and yourself and Roseanne have done a lot of work with T.G. Cahir and in different groups. What idea have you come up with for to help people through this? It's a lovely, lovely idea.
Yeah, well, I can't take credit. It's Roseanne, of course, my sister.
Roseanne
is filming me every day. We're going live on Roseanne's Facebook page because I don't really use Facebook, but not too much anyway. And so every day we're going live and I'm reading a chapter from the book, a chapter a day. So we started on Monday. Today I'm on chapter 4 and there are 75 chapters in all. And we just thought, I got some copies from the publisher lately as well, so I have them to sell. It's almost 2 years exactly since it was published. So as a way of marking that, as a way of giving people a little bit of our little contribution, we thought they'd enjoy it because the story, the memories are light and it's all about nostalgia. I read the first one on Monday, games we used to play, and it's all about in Lower Newtown in Waterford in the 60s how we used to play hopscotch and skipping out on the street. And I remember I read that at Booze, Blaz and Banter in Jordan's on the Quay in Waterford a couple of years ago. And everybody was there. They all joined in the little verses that I read out, you know, Dashy Mrs. Brown, Dashy Mrs. Brown, Dashy, 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 all these things. When I am dead and in my grave and I am quite forgotten, these two balls will tell you my age and all of that. And everybody, all the men and women of my own age were able to join in. And it was just lovely. So that was Monday. Yesterday then, it was weird. Chapter 3, it's called My Mother's Mandolin. And it's only a little story, a memory of how we were playing upstairs in the attic, jumping from bed to bed. And didn't we break the mandolin? And it's the little story about that. But then dawned on me, it was my mother's birthday yesterday. You know, it's funny the way things happen. So we're having great fun doing it. You know, it's live. So Roseanne goes kind of, you know, she presses the button and I'm live. And I'm just reading the chapter. So I don't know. I hope people, I have friends in New York and I have another friend, she's a writer. She's got a huge following in Australia. So I'm hoping people will enjoy it. Their comments on they love my accent, you know, my Waterford accent.
Yes.
And
No, it's a lovely idea. And people are, coming up with different ideas about how to communicate and keep together. And I know a lot of the hurlers and footballers are doing keepy uppies and doing little competitions. And this is a lovely live streaming. And it's on, as you say, Roseanne's Facebook page.
Yeah, 5 o'clock every day we do it. And then we put it up on YouTube.
Roseanne Foley, R-O-S-E-A-N-N Foley. Type in that. And then you put it up on YouTube. So 5 o'clock every day, you read it.
It's just chapter. Beyond the breakwater. Whatever, so that's usually the way it goes.
So if you do a chapter a day, it should bring you up to the end of May. Is there 75 chapters?
That's what I figure. If Roseanne can last the page, I'd love to keep going, you know.
I tell you. Well, Anne Watson has texted in to say, well done, Catherine and Roseanne. Fabulous. You were in school with Catherine and...
I remember Anne,
in the Prez.
In the Prez and Dungarvan. So the book kind of follows my lot in Waterford. Then we moved to Rinkt and Ryan to the Gaeltacht. And then it's about my life, first student in UCC and teaching, and then as a journalist in Dublin. And then the final section is my return and the last years with my parents. Some of them are a bit sad maybe, but they're all kind of, I think they are mostly upbeat. You know, kind of happy memories, I think, you know, funny things.
No, they are. I've read the book, and as you know, there's connections there with Passage East as well. There's some lovely stories, and it's a great idea. Listen, mind yourself, Catherine.
Thanks, Damien. Lovely to be talking to you in this strange time. Take care. Yeah.
There'll be another book. There'll be a lot of books written about this period, won't there? There'll be movies made about this.
Yeah, and your work in Roseanne said we feel like we're the only people working in the country. You know the way when you sit at your desk, the whole thing seems to be kind of falling off the table.
Yeah. Well, we will prevail. That's the important. We will prevail. And that's so important. Listen, say hello to Roseanne and to all your family and to everybody in Unrhyne, Ganairi and Tallaght, okay?
And you too, lovely to talk to you. Thurara the Tain. Slán, lad.
Slán go fóill. Slán go fóill, Catherine. Catherine Foley there from Unrhyne, and you heard her talk about that's 5 o'clock every day, and other people have been texting in about other matters. The Dial a Prayer number, it's 2 o'clock today, and it's 085-7611-822. Dial a Prayer, 7611-822. Ger has texted in, you're playing a blinder, everybody in WLR. You have me in tears. My son Jono and his fiance had a baby girl, Bonnie, last week. God only knows when I will hold her. My daughter is a nurse in the hospital as well. So worrying times, but stay safe, everyone. That's from Ger. Ger, very good advice, very simple. And yes, to everybody in the family, stay safe. Please, I'm a patient in the hospital. Can you wish all the staff and medics on duty here? They're working flat out night and day. They really are. They're working flat out night and day. Damon was watching The Chase last night. One of the questions was, what was a Waterford blah? And the contestant got it right. That is in from Mick. Can you please say hello and play a Red Hurley song? I'm not going to play Red Hurley this morning. To my elder sister Rita, her fantastic husband Brendan Russell, home listening to your show. From all 7 brothers and 2 sisters. I think that's from Mary. Hello from Abbeyside and a little bit of heaven in Abbeyside. Keep up the great work. That's from Anne in Abbeyside, the Eurovision songs. So we've got a joint competition winner for our Eurovision. We've got 2 songs and we're going to play as much of them as we can now before the end of the programme. And we're going to start with, I suppose, the slower one, and we'll end with a bit more of an upbeat. Thanks for all your texts into the show this morning. Thanks for all your comments. We have had a phenomenal amount of texts and comments. People ringing in, people on the WhatsApp, people texting, and I can't get to them all. I tried to get to as many as possible, and I want to try and get the programme moving along as much as possible. People are texting about the NCT centres, for example, that they need to have a lot more hand washers and things there. And also people talking about the mechanics, and the mechanics are they're doing a great job there, and want to wish all of them very, very safety. So for all the patients and everybody working in the hospitals, this is for you. So if you know this song, sing it loud. Here we go. Johnny Logan, Hold Me Now.